G'day viewers, it's Peter from my Bonza channel. Last week I showed you a review on Luminar, the photo editor. Today I'm going to do another review. It's on InPixio and it's on their photo clip. So the question you're all asking is InPixio as good as they make it look when they're advertising the photo clip? No, where they remove the background. Today I'm going to remove the background on what I think is a pretty complicated image. And you'll see it working in action for real, no crap. All right, so before we go and do that, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that little bell so you don't miss out on future publications of my videos. And right now, off we go to show you how InPixio really works. So we're going to open InPixio and we're going to use the photo cutter. Right, so we're going to pick one of my photos. So we're going to open the photo up. Okay, we'll do this one here. So the way I like using it is I'm going to use paint areas I want to keep. Let's make my brush a little bit bigger and you just sort of highlight the areas that you want to keep quickly. Might have to adjust it a little bit later. Probably just need to get rid of that because I made it a little bit too big. We've got to make sure we keep it in within the lines. You'll notice all the blue parts, that's what's been erased. You know the arrow has been erased, so what you do is you make your brush size a little bit smaller. And we're just gonna paint that arrow in. Get the hand as well. And also that stick. Club, spear thing, whatever it is he's holding in his hand. We'll make the image a bit smaller. And you can already see how most of it has been, most of the background has been erased. And then a little bit of blue there. So then you paint the areas that you want to remove. So that little bit of blue there, so we're just gonna put a bit of a line in there. We'll make the brush a little bit bigger and we paint, we get rid of all this again. Because when I selected that blue, it made all the blue acceptable. So now we have to get rid of that. And also that green and also all this other crap around here. Whoops, a little bit too far. Control Z on the Mac to undo the last bit. Okay, we'll go out again. And you can see how that's coming out pretty well. There's a few little bits and pieces like in there, so we just make your brush size smaller. Probably not too small. You want to be able to see it. And just a little bit here. Quickly check it, so you'll find there's a bit here. I'll get rid of that, get rid of this.
Probably not that bit there. Oh, yeah, we'll get rid of that. And then I've noticed that we've lost his hand and his spear, or his arrow, so we just make the brush a bit smaller and you paint those areas in to keep. There, you never do it straight. And now that's working, you can notice how it's finishing it off nicely. We just need that little bit here, so we gotta paint to get rid of that. And the reason it's kept it is because it's so close to the actual color of the image that you want to keep. And you can see it working when you just move your mouse over and you'll see what you need to touch up. And there's that bit over here where his foot is. I painted a bit too much, so we're going to get rid of that. Now we just move the mouse off and have a look. And you can see that's starting to go. Probably a little bit more here. And that sky, get rid of that. Probably because I went a little bit too wide on my keep thing on the arrow. That sky's come back there, so we'll get rid of that. Whoops, a bit too much maybe. Make that a little bit smaller now. And then there's a little bit there where his arm is. So we need to get rid of that. So brush size smaller once again. Go in there a little bit. And just here, make it a little bit smaller again. And it looks pretty good. Double checking a little bit, and you can notice I've missed a little bit here, so we'll get rid of that. And that should disappear in a sec. There she goes. And it's still working, it actually smooths all the edges. Okay, so that's pretty well lit. So what I'll do then, once I've got rid of most of it, I just will cut this section out because I don't need all that image. And that's my warriors fighting with a transparent image. And I've actually submitted that to Dreamtime. And just to show you, there it is there. And those of you who go on Dreamtime, you know that they're very particular with what images they accept. If they find anything even slightly wrong with it, they won't accept it. So the fact that they've accepted this image just shows you how good InPixio is. So there you go, guys. How to remove a background with InPixio. I hope you like that little tutorial. As far as I'm concerned, InPixio is a great program. I have used other programs to delete backgrounds, and none of them have worked as well. So once again, it's Peter, my Bonzi channel. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and click that little bell to make sure you get notified of future videos. Hope to see you soon. Peter, my Bonzi channel, signing off.